All right, I think we have Alicia. Are you out there, Alicia?
Yes.
Hi, you have some homework you'd like to do. Is that correct?
Yes.
I'm heading over to the board. What kind of homework are we working on tonight, Alicia?
A math question.
Excellent. So what is your math question that we're going to do?
Okay. Mr. Walton has $3,000 in his bank account.
Okay.
Mrs. Nelson has 10 times as much in her bank account.
Okay.
How much money does Miss Nelson have in her bank account?
All right, so what do you think we have to do, Alicia, to solve this question?
Multiply.
All right, and how are we going to do that? Because we have 3,000, and we have the Mrs. Nelson, I think, has 10 times as much. So what are we going to have to do?
We can multiply 10 times 3,000.
All right, or 3,000 times 10, either way. I'm going to show you a really quick trick. So if I write 3,000, and I put a 1 and a 0 underneath here, and then when I multiply that, all I'm really doing is bringing down a 0. Because I know the 1 is not going to change any of my other numbers. They're going to stay the same numbers. So I put a comma after the 3. Another thing that's really nice with multiplying by tens or hundreds or thousands, all I really have to do is look at how many zeros I have after the 1 or the 100 or the 1,000. And add that to my original number when I multiply.
Okay.
Okay. Do you have another one, or would you like to try another one?
I have another one.
All right. Well, let's go to your other one. What do you got?
An eatery restaurant has 200 tables.
200 tables.
Yes.
Okay.
There are reservations for 1/10 of the tables.
So we have 1/10 of the tables. Okay. We have reservations for 1/10. And what do you think we have to do now? We have to figure out what 1/10 of that whole thing is, right?
Yes.
All right. So now, if we have 1/10, that means we're going to do what?
Do 1/10 of 200.
Yeah, so that means we're actually going to divide, right? We're going to divide 200 by 10.
Okay.
Right? So now the same thing is going to apply. If I'm doing hundreds, tens, thousands with no other numbers in there, all I'm really going to do is move my decimal one place over. Now we can do this, we'll do it the long way here. We got 200, and we're going to divide this by 10. And I know and you know that 10 goes into 20 how many times?
Twice.
It goes in 2, and I multiply, I get 20. And when I subtract, I get 0, and I bring my 0 down. So I know 10 goes into 0, 0 times. So what I'm actually doing when I divide by 10 and hundreds or thousands, I'm moving my decimal place over. Now, another way we can do this is, if I multiply 200, what is 1/10 as a decimal?
1/10 as a decimal?
Yes.
I'm not sure.
Well, it's going to be 1 divided by 10, which is going to be 0.1. Okay?
Okay.
So now if I multiply 200 by 0.1, I go 1 times 0 is 0, 1 times 0 is 0, 1 times 2 is 2. In my numbers now, I have to look at how many places do I have after the decimal. I only have 1, so right there is my same thing. So now I've shown you like 3 different ways that you can divide by factors of 10, hundreds, or thousands, or multiply the same way by tens, hundreds, or thousands. Okay, Alicia, that was fantastic. You call back with some more of those anytime, okay?
Okay, thank you.
You're welcome.